Hi, I'm Joe Gertis, and this is Coffee in the Capital. Our guest today is Senator Wayne Langerhold, representing the 35th Senatorial District. Mr. Chairman, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me, Joe.
Senator, of course, you're no stranger to PSATs or township government, having served as a township supervisor yourself for Richland Township as a Pennsylvania State Senator and Chairman of the Transportation Committee.
Yes, I think it prepared me very well and gave me really a strong foundation. I can think back to when I was even a senior in high school and I was in student council, and we had the opportunity to go to our local township, Richland Township, and run a mock meeting. And then it was from there I kind of learned. And then actually that led to my first job with the township, actually. That summer, I inquired as to, what work they might have, thinking that maybe there's something, in the office, because I was kind of interested in politics, maybe law school. And then they said, we have a position on the road crew open. So it was a little different than what I kind of anticipated at the beginning, but I'll tell you what, it really, really helped form me a lot. I had the opportunity to work for the public works, for the road department, I worked there actually every summer after high school through college and up until law school. And that gave me really the opportunity to, number one, learn the township, every road within the township, and deal with people kind of at that beginning. And then the opportunity to be appointed to the board. I kind of knew the township, knew every kind of nook and cranny Richland Township. And that really, they say all politics is local. I mean, you don't get much more local than that. They know where you live and they know what the issues are affecting. And being able to deal with those issues on a smaller scale really helped form the basis for government. And then having the opportunity to travel to the township convention in Hershey, which was very, just a great opportunity to learn and to grow and to meet other individuals from across the state.
Well, Senator, when we talk about transportation, this is something we've talked about quite a bit on Coffee in the Capital. It's such an important role, obviously, for our Commonwealth and our comprehensive transportation system, from our local roads all the way up to our state roads and the turnpike. And funding it is a pretty hot topic, and it's not an easy one. And you're right in the middle of looking at how we fund this transportation network for the future. And I know that you have put out your idea of how we should proceed in the Drive Smart Act, which is really really does take a comprehensive look at how we go about transportation. And moving into the future here, and just wanted to see if you could share some of your key thoughts there.
Yes, so just got the opportunity to be named the chairman of the Transportation Committee here in January. So I thought it was important, we want to meet with all the stakeholders involved across the transportation spectrum, because we're hearing different things, that there's not enough funding, that they need different revenue sources. So what better way to address that than to hear from everybody that's involved, that has a hand in it. And after meeting with those stakeholders and taking a look, across the spectrum, that kind of what the first thing that we saw as, being the name of the chairman, was that bridge tolling initiative. They're trying to toll these bridges. And that kind of led the basis to, hey, let's take a step back here. Let's see what we can do to, best address this. And I'll point back to my days, as a township supervisor, we'd sit in the caucus room and with a pencil and a paper and go through the budget line by line, right. Where are we going to get this money from? And let's be true stewards of the tax dollar. And this is no different. I mean, it's on a much grander scale. As we met with these stakeholders and tried to determine what's the best option here, how do we make this work? We need to, need to think outside the box. And we need to take a look at all different departments. And that's what this plan really encompasses, is not just one simple fix for, this big revenue source, but really taking a look all around. Number one, look at PennDOT spending.
Yeah, how can we save money, not just throw money? Yeah.
Absolutely. I sit on the Appropriations Committee, and every year these different departments come before us and they ask for, it seems like they always ask for more money. It's never less. And we say, why is it why are you asking for X amount of dollars? Well, it was this last year. Well, let's take a look at how we're spending it, and instead of just automatically assuming that that's going to be the dollar figure.
Right.
So that's one component. Another is, you know, dealing with some other, you know, revenue sources. There was a pilot program for electric vehicles to pay a mileage-based fee. There is bonding, and Pennsylvania receives about $2 billion every year from the federal government, from federal monies for transportation. We are proposing to take a very small piece of that every year to bond. It's about $100 million, which will then leverage about $2 billion to infuse into these capital projects. And also with that, make sure that that is spent appropriately. And that's not just thrown, you know, we're not just throwing money around. We were able to allocate this budget $279 million, which is a part of this plan as well, from the Federal Rescue Plan Act, and, you know, those dollars to then help alleviate some of these problems. And I want to make it, you know, very, you know, clear from the outset, as we hear from PennDOT saying, we don't have enough money, and we need $8 billion. And we just accept that figure on its face. Really, if we were able to allocate $8 billion, if we were able to allocate those dollars tomorrow, there still isn't, PennDOT doesn't have the capacity to make all those projects happen. So we need to make sure that we agree on a number here of what we need, and we need to work towards that collaboratively and really, you know, rein in our belts and spend appropriately.
How do you see that partnership with the Commonwealth and the locals moving forward in the future?
Yes, it's very important that we continue those liquid fuels. Those are dollars that are very essential to townships' budgets, absolutely 100%. And part of that is making sure that the money that is generated from the gas tax goes to its intended purpose. Now, of that, there's what, $700 million, I believe, that goes out of the motor license fund into an allocation to the state police.
Right.
We need, and I'm not by any means, I'm not saying that we don't need to allocate our dollars to our state police. You know, I spent the better part of my career in law enforcement as an assistant district attorney in Cambria County. We need to properly fund our state police, but we need to take that and find a dedicated revenue source instead of having this political battle every budgetary year to ensure that those dollars are properly allocated to that. So that's another component, you know, to the Drive Smart Act that we have, is to address that issue going forward.
What are some of the other priorities you and your colleagues in the Senate are thinking about in the fall session?
We're going to continue to work to get our economy back to work. And that encompasses a lot, you know, making sure that we are business friendly, that we're not putting oppressive regulations on our small businesses, and also getting people back to work.
Well, Mr. Chairman, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you for taking the time to join us here at PSATs on Coffee in the Capitol. And remember, if you like what you're seeing, subscribe to PSAT's YouTube channel and follow our social media pages for more Township Video News content. Next Tuesday, look for Dave Talk. And as always, thanks for watching.